Here again, two phases are connected. So these are again, this comes under the multi-phase flow applications. Then when we are talking about the environmental control, so most of the systems at the sewage water treatment plants, whether it may be your power sector also, or we can say a sewage treatment plants, erosion and debris. So here you will have most of the debris, or we can say solid form will be mixing with the liquid form. So this kind of application also falls under the multi-phase flow. So this comes actually this subcategory, this can subcategorize into the environmental controls. Then when we are talking about the CFD modeling, so CFD modeling, as you most of you guys are aware about the CFD modeling. So basically CFD modeling itself is a complex phenomenon, because there we are dealing with the turbulence, phase change, chemistry. So that's, and when we are talking about the multi-phase flow, so there are two different phases that has to be solved. The equation, Navier-Stokes equation, has to be solved for both the phases, or we can say the different parameter has to be evaluated, such as volume fraction and related phenomena. So basically CFD modeling gives us the insight, detailed insight related to the flow regime, how the flow is happening, or what are the holdup, how the size distribution will be there. For example, if you are using the spray dryer, not spray dryer, sprinkler, so you will be able to get the actual the tracking of that small water droplets through into the air domain. So that is nothing but size distribution. So that kind of phenomena, actually CFD helps us to give the detailed insight related to this multi-phase flow CFD modeling. Now then here comes the basic difference between the multi-phase flow and the multi-species flow. So basically when we are talking about the multi-phase flow, so here you can observe the image which consists of the mixture of oil as well as the water. So here you can actually clearly identify the where the oil is located and where the water is located. Now both phases are separated by some kind of distinct interfaces. But when we are talking about the second image, so second image is nothing but the combination of alcohol and the water. So these are actually mixed on the molecular level. So we cannot actually identify how, where the water is located as well as where the alcohol is located. So this actually falls on the in the multi-species categories. So basically when we are talking about the multi-phase category, the mixing happens on a non-molecular basis, and when we are talking about the multi-species application, the mixing is happening on the molecular basis. So that in the multi-phase application, we do have the clear-cut interfaces between the two phases. So so all the air, or we can see a smoke, even the smoke also, it those categories are falling into the multi-species applications. So instead of two phases also in the modeling, we can actually go for the numerous phases, such as two or three or four also. But since we are increasing from two to more number of phases, your computational time will be increasing. Sai, am I audible? Because I am seeing the message of the voice lagging.
Hello, Ravi. Audio is lagging at your side. Can you ensure that you have closed other applications, and if you have any drive application which are in active sharing, can you pause them also? Try to close all other your internet applications except this.
Okay, so now coming to the classification of multi-phase flow. So basically when we are talking about the multi-phase flow, or even the different phases, as we have learned from the childhood, there are the three different phases. One is gaseous phase, one is solid phase, and another next one is a liquid phase. So these are the three, nothing but the three phases which we are talking about: gas, solid, and the liquid. And the combination of gas solid, or the liquid solid, or the gas liquid is nothing but the multi-phase flow, where two phases are combining to give the another product, or we can say another result. So when we are starting with the gaseous flow to the solid flow, gaseous phase to the solid phase, first of all the category is coming to the smoke. So when you have observed any smoke, there you will be observing the majority of the gaseous flow, but there will be small dilute particles will be there that will be causing that we can see as solid particles. But also this category of the smoke is coming into the multi spaces because it has a multiple the environment multiple spaces consist of it. Now when we are moving to the little bit to the solid phase, from the gaseous to the solid phase, then comes the dust. So you have also the song or something like that. This is nothing but the where major flow will be your gaseous flow, and the dust, that is nothing but the solid particles are consist of the dust, or we can see as soil particles. Then comes the dilute particle cloud. So for example, if you have observed the bean bag, so when we are spreading those beans into the some kind of closed chamber, or even not even a closed chamber, into some kind of environment, that kind of applications are there. This lots of beans are where actually freely able to move into that certain chamber. So that is nothing but the diluted particle cloud. Now when we are talking about the dense particle cloud, so when we are to, so for example, marbles are there. So so marble, when we are allowing the marble to flow through a certain channel or certain path, those marbles will be the colliding to each other, as well as the those are flowing with a particular majority of the flow. Then when we are to, when we are coming onto the major flow, which is nothing but a solid. So solid, this red categories has been classified into the packed, or we can say porous medium simulations. So for example, if packed bed is nothing but the marbles are packed in a closed chamber, which the marbles will not able to move through it. Only the some there will be some kind of porosity will be there, so that through that porosity the water, or we can say air, will be allowed to move through that. Now when we are going from the solid phase to the liquid phase, there will be a fluidized bed. So fluidized bed is nothing but the water. But in the dominant phase will be here, will be the liquid, and it will be driving the solid particle along with it. Now this is the major researchable area, is nothing but the gas liquid flows. So when we are talking about the liquid and the gaseous phase interactions, first of all, when we are talking about the diluted bubbly flow, so diluted bubbly, that means you will be having the air bubbles in the liquid flow, or we can say liquid water tubes. So diluted bubbly is then comes the dense bubbly. So the density of these bubbles, air bubbles, is increased a little bit. So when you observe the or something the cold drinks, so when you are opening that coke bottle or the cold drink bottle, you will be observing small particles of the this small bubbles, air bubbles are flowing at the top of the surfaces. That is kind of the this dense and diluted bubbly flow. Then when we are talking about the stratified flow, so stratified flow is nothing but the combination. So here both the phases will be the equivalent, or we can say a dominant phases, the gaseous as well as the liquid. But when so for example, examples of these are the water flowing through the river. So when water flows through the river, we are able to clearly identify the interface or the level of the water. When we are saying that this is the level of water, so that means that till that level water phase will be there, and above that level air phase will be there. So there will be clear cut distinct interfaces between the both the phases, such as air as well as the liquid. Another example is nothing but your liquid tank or the tanks washing applications kind of thing. Then comes the churn application. So churn application is nothing but the combination of the so this is actually basically a transition from the stratified flows to the gaseous flow. So for example, in the gear splashing, oil splashing application in the gear, so below that, when this total gears are dipped into the oil, so that will be acting as a your VOF, or not VOF, that is stratified flows. And when those are churning or coming in between the two gear teeth, there will be a distortion of that phases. So that will be another. So that is the nothing but the transition. Now next phase, or we can say next, when we are moving to the majority to the gaseous phase, here the spray or the droplet flow. So here spray or the droplet flow is nothing but our sprinkler, or even the jet spray is nothing but these are the application, because here the water droplets will be flowing through the air. So here major or primary phase will be the gaseous phase, and the secondary will be the water or the liquid phase. Here in this dense bubble or diluted bubble, primary phase will be your liquid phase or the water phase, and the secondary will be your air phase or the gaseous phase. And next one is a wet steam. So here the majority of your gas will be there, and the little bit of water droplets, or we can say water vapor will be there. So this is actually basically the classification of the multi-phase flow according to the different phases, such as gas, solid, and the liquids. So now when we are moving to the next phase, first of all, we will be talking about the classification of the gas solid flow. So here the gas solid flow, here if you observe here, this is the densely cloud, and this is diluted one. So here the number of particles are very large as compared to the diluted one. So here when we are definition to this diluted flow is nothing but this volume of these particles, the small red particles, should be less than the 10% of this volume of the cuboid. So in order to classify into the diluted bubbly flow. So this is the basic difference. Then when we are talking about the different phase couplings here, so when we are talking about the dense flow, there are again so different phases will be there. One will be your dominant phase, or we can see a primary phase, and the secondary will be secondary will be the solid red particles are nothing but the secondary phase. But when we are talking about the phase coupling application here, so the first of all, the what are the forces will be exerted by this. So first we'll talk about the direct only. So when what are the forces will be exerted by this tube, the primary phase will be exerted on the direct flow, and according to the motion of the primary phase, these red particles will move along that directions. But in case of the dense flow, there are again certain parameters will be there. So there will be a coupling between different phases particle to particle force will be exerted, such as collision will be there. Then the contacts will be there. So this kind, when we are talking about this kind of applications, then comes another method from the fluid side. These are the DEM method. So for example, when we are talking about the marble, so when marbles are collide each other, they will be exerting that force as well onto each other, right? There will be a contact as well as a collision will be there. So when we are talking about the computational time, or we can say a computational expenses are more in case of this dense categories. Now on the liquid solid flows. So here these are the nothing categories of the these are nothing but the slurry transportation, or even the we can say that the wastewater treatment plant. Here these are the applications are there. So here your the majority of the flow will be the primary flow will be the liquid one, or the, we can say water, and the your small particles or a slurry, or we can say as wastage, can be treated as a secondary phase. This is the most research area, nothing but the gas liquid flow. So first of all, we will be focusing only on the dispersed and the separated flow. So the dispersed flow is nothing but the phase, or we can say the dispersed phase and the separated phase. So dispersed phase is nothing but the phase that doesn't have any clear cut interfaces, or we can say clear cut. It goes under the various distortion as compared to primary phase. So when you are observing this image, so first of all, this is the circle. Then it is getting converted into some elliptical. Then again, it is deforming into another shape, and again it is deforming into another shape. So changing shape.
Hello, Ravi.
Yes, I.
Hello, Ravi. Ravi, can you go at a somewhat slower pace, and even when you are trying to switch the slide, right, just hold for a couple, 1 second after the slide gets changed, and then you continue the audio. Because we are able to, while the slide is getting transition, we are hearing some breakage in your voice. So after the slide gets transition, you resume your voice, or you can continue speaking, all those things.
Okay, sure, sir. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, so I will start again explaining about this slide. So when we are talking about the gas liquid flow, so gas liquid flow is nothing but the one phase will be in your gaseous form, another phase will be in liquid form. So then when we are talking So the dispersed phase interface. So when talking about the dispersed phase, so dispersed phase is nothing but that phase doesn't have the specific shape. So that shape, that specific shape, or we can say the shape of the dispersed phase will be getting distorted according to the phase interaction between the with the another phase. For example, this light blue, this or we can say gray is the one another phase, and this blue color portion is the one dispersed phase. So as it is traveling to the upward, if you observe that. Observing that the circular in shape and getting distorted to the elliptical form, then again it is getting distorted to the some other form as it is traveling upwards. So this is due to the phase interaction between the two different phases. So that is nothing but this phase, we can call it as a dispersed phase, and this gray color phase we can call it as a continuous phase or the separated phase. So talking about the examples of the dispersed flows, our first one is a motion of bubbles in the liquid flow, motion of the liquid droplets in the gaseous phase, or the motion of dispersed liquid droplets in another liquid, such as the image we saw, the combination of oil and the water. That is nothing but the just a second. Another liquid, such as the image we have seen previous slides, mixing of the oil and the water. So these are the examples of the dispersed flow, where your one phase will be the dominant phase and another will be the dispersed phase. Dispersed phase, you mean it will be in the, it will not have perfect shape. It will be in the most of the transition, or you can say. So whatever the separated flow. Now when we are coming to the combination of the both the flows, like such as the dispersed as well as the continuous flow. So here one phase will be in the dispersed manner and the second phase will be in the continuous manner. So again the examples will be repeated here, such as rain or the soft drinks or the slurry and the immiscible liquid droplets. For example, in the rain, your air will be the continuous and the water will be the dispersed flow. Soft drinks, your liquid will be the continuous phase, and the basically consist of the dispersed phase. One will be the dispersed phase and next one will be the continuous phase. So here soft drinks liquid will be your the continuous phase, and the bubbles will be your dispersed phase. In case of rain, air will be your continuous phase, air will be your dispersed phase. In the drain, the air droplets will be your dispersed phase and the water will be your continuous phase. So likewise, so we'll see the few examples in this few next slides. Next come the separated system. So separated system consists of the both the flows phase as a continuous phase. So it is nothing but the continuous flows. So open channel flow, mold filling, or we can say a dam break, or the gas tank filling, or the sloshing are comes under the separated system flow. So when we are seeing the animation, you can clearly get this one. So here the one red one will on one phase, and the blue one will be another phase. For example, this is the animation of the dam break. So here the blue portion is nothing but the water and the red portion is nothing but the air. But here if you observe, both the phases are in a continuous manner. So, but just the interface is little bit there, which is separating these both the phases according to the phase interaction phenomenon. So, in case of we don't have this example. We have the example of this dispersed system in the next slides. So, when we are talking about the multi-phase flow modeling approaches in the ANSYS Fluent,
So first one is the nothing but the Eulerian model approach. So we have the different categories of when we are modeling the multiphase flow in the ANSYS Fluent. So we have the first one is nothing but the Eulerian model approach. So Eulerian model approach is useful when we have the when we want to solve the it for the dispersed system. So dispersed system is nothing but we have seen the dispersed system. Dispersed system is nothing but it consists of one it will be your dispersed phase and another one will be your continuous phase. So here ideally when we are looking at the background of the Eulerian approach, so this differential equations or we can say the Navier-Stokes equations are solved separately for each phases. It will be solved separately for the dispersed phase as well as for the continuous phase. So in, we are talking about the computationally expensive as compared to the other models. It is the most computationally expensive as compared to the VOF model, I can say, the mixture model. Then the it actually describes the, so it actually solves the Navier-Stokes equation separately for both the phases. So example, when we are talking about the Eulerian model example, same such as the gas liquid phases in this one, then we have to add those phases at the secondary phases. But as we are increasing the number of secondary phases in our model, the computational time to solve this all the phases will be the increasing exponentially. When we are, it will be the most computationally expensive because as we have seen that this differential equations or we can say Navier-Stokes equation are solved separately for the each phases. So that will be constituting, that will be making a difference here when we are adding the more number of secondary phases. So here are a few examples of the Eulerian model approach. So this is the bubble column example. So this bubble column, the blue portion is nothing but the one, the major phase, or we can see a primary phase, and this bubble column is rising through the respective setting. So this is the left side, you can see the volume fraction contour of the phase two. Phase two is nothing but this red portion. So how this is interacting with the primary phase, or we can say a continuous phase. Now the next example is nothing but the three-phase rising slurry. So here this is the one phase, this is the second phase, blue portion is the second phase, and the solid particles are rising through the from bottom to the top. So these are nothing but the three-phase flow actually. And the next one is a fluidized bed. So this is a fluidized bed with the internal options is nothing but it also falling under this Eulerian model examples. Now, when we are talking about the multiphase flow consolidation in the 2020 R1, so current release is nothing, current release of the ANSYS is 2020 R1. So previously, what we have to do is we have to open this multiphase flow modeling, or we can say multiphase flow window. We have to set the particular model. We have to close that window. Again, we have to set the phase interaction panel. We have to set this primary phase, which one will be our primary phase, which one will be our secondary phase. And again, after closing them, we will be setting this phase interaction settings here. So that is actually closing of the tabular window and again opening the same window. That will be, so that has been consolidated in the 2020 R1 version. So this is also previously it was like this. So in the 2020 R1, in the single window, we can actually select all these settings. So first of all, in the models, we are selecting the models. Secondly, we are selecting the phases here. And thirdly, we are setting the phase interaction in this panel. And the one addition of the population balance model also has been made available here. Okay, sorry. Made available here, which previously in the 2019, R3 version, we can access it through only the UI command, but now it is we can access it through the GUI as well. Now, when we are coming to the phase setting, so we have seen the, we have selected the models here, let's say the Eulerian models we have selected. Now comes the phase setting. So in order to select this phase, which one will be our primary phase and which one will be our secondary phase, because before setting this phase, we have to make sure that we are adding those particular phase of the particular material in the material section of the ANSYS Fluent. So when once, for example, if we have two phases, which we are dealing with, one is water and one is air. By default, Ansys Fluent has always had the air as a material. But in order to make sure that we also defining the primary phases and the secondary phases, we are also adding the water in the material section, and then we are accessing this phase panel, or we can say a phase setting panel. Here actually we can define this primary phase and the secondary phase, which one will be our primary phase and which one will be our secondary phase. Now when we are defining this in case of granular flow, in case of Eulerian flow, we are setting certain diameter with for the secondary phase flow, secondary phase. So we have the several ways to define it. So one is the quarter mean, or we can say even we can also set the constant diameter, or even if we have certain drag law, or we can say our one certain equation through which the diameter of this phase will be changing, then also we can set it to the user-defined functions. Now comes the most important settings in the multi-phase flow application is nothing but the phase interaction setting. So phase interaction setting, in here we are actually defining how these two phases are interacting with each other. So for example, air and water will be there. So how those two will be interacting to each other. So whether there will be a, how the drag will be there between these two phases, or we can say how lift will be there if it is there, if there will be there in the heat transfer, or if there is any mass transfer, how the surface tension will be there. So that has these values we have to define here. For example, if the mass transfer is there, so for example, evaporation or the condensation, or even we can say a cavitation will be there, then we have to opt for this particular settings in case of in the phase interaction panel. Also in the surface tension, how these both are interacting to each other, for example, air and the water. So whatever when we are water droplet, or air bubbles are there, so those are rising when we are those are rising from the bottom to the top side of the liquid flow. So this is nothing but the due to the phase interaction, or you can say a surface tension phenomena between the both the phases. So this is the key, these are the key settings we have to make sure that we are defining of the phase interaction setting. Now second way is the Eulerian granular model setup. So here we are considering the secondary phase as a granular, or we can say a solid particle. So for example, the dust flow will be there, likewise that can be modeled as a granular. So the procedure is same as the Eulerian flow, but just we have to opt for the granular flow as a secondary phase as a granular flow, and according to the granular flow we have to define the different number of properties, such as viscosity, granular viscosity will be there, then the bulk viscosity, frictional viscosity will be there, diameter will be there. So there are again different laws will be there to set this one. So according to your applications, according to your requirement, you can definitely set the different viscosities in the for the granular phase. Now the third one is the VOF model setup, or we can say volume of fluid model setup. So previous two cases are actually useful when we have a dispersed system flow, or we can say dispersed system. But when we are talking about the VOF model setup, this actually useful when we have the separated system, or we can say a stratified system. Here the both the phases will be in a continuous manner. So here so VOF actually useful when used to model the immiscible fluids with a clearly defined the interface. So as we saw in that dam break animation, the air was of the blue portion and the water was of the red portion. So there actually clearly there is certain interface was there. So that is nothing but the defined interface. So this kind of simulations we can actually model or do in case of VOF model setting. So this is we have to set the volume of fluid model in the multiphase model selection. Eulerian phases we can set it out in the number of phases. If we have more number of phases, we can also set the more number of phases here. So here we are interacting with the two, then the two. So basically what it does is, so here is the single set of Navier-Stokes equation will be solved for both the phases. It may be for the continuous, so both the phases, whatever, how many other phases will be there, which those will be solved in the continuous, those are single set of governing equations will be solved. So here the basic difference will be the using the volume of fraction. So what are the volume of fraction of the first phase as compared to the second phase? According to that will be the governing parameter here in the case of Navier-Stokes equation that we, according to that, these equations are getting modified and solved, solved accordingly. So when you are talking about the accuracy of the VOF, so actually as fine as our mesh is, that it will give a clear-cut interface. When you are using the coarser mesh, that will be the your if you observe the coarser, we are observing the. Difference here is explicit will be giving you the more clarity, or we can say a more accurate interface. But in order to use this explicit formulation, you have to make sure that you are using the correct mesh, because highly skewed elements will not be applicable in case of explicit. So there are again other settings are here definitely has to be explored in case of your model setup. Then when we are talking about the applications of the VOF, there are several applications of the VOF, such as the wave impact on the loading, or we can say the primary automation will be there, or the tank flushing, tank filling application will be there, the test for the fuel randomization, gas lubrication will be there, the different kind of fabrication of now will be there, the kind of application can be addressed to the problem of fuel model. Now the fourth one is the discrete phase model. So here, discrete phase model is somewhat similar to the Eulerian granular model, which we have seen in the second option. But here the major difference is this dispersed phase, that is the granular phase, is tracked in the Lagrangian reference frame. So Lagrangian reference frame, that means for each particle, it is for each particle, the distribution of solid frequency and the tracking of the particular particle has been specified, or we can say, solved in the Lagrangian reference frame. So here, discrete frame is modeled by the Lagrangian method, and the continuous frame is modeled by using the Eulerian method. So to switch on, so when we are looking for the DPM option, or we can say discrete frame modeling option, these are the general models, previous three models we can set it on, we can switch on from the multi-phase flow modeling. And for the two, in order to switch on the discrete phase, we have to opt for this discrete phase option. And again, there are several settings over there when we are talking about the interaction. So also the particle treatment, unsteady particle tracking can be done, or even the interaction with the continuous phase will be there. Then again, when we are talking about the tracking or the physical modeling, even the physical model we are talking about, when we are, there is a collision between the two different particles, or we can say marbles. So for that, in order to capture that collision between two different models, we have to switch on the DEM modeling. So that can be switched on through the physical model. So again, there are certain other options are there, different settings are there. And one is there, this injection. So injection is a point through which it will be, the particles will be injecting into the domain. So that in different types of injection will be there, such as conical injection, group injection, point injection, surface injection will be there. So through that, these particles will be injecting into the continuous space, and these particles will be tracked in the Lagrangian meter. So basically, both the phases are coupled by source of in the governing equation. Again, there are certain assumptions for this DPM validation is that the volume fraction should be lower than the 0.1 as compared to the primary phases. So these are the certain examples here when we are talking about the. So first one, this is a clear cyclone separator, or we can say similar application is for spray dryer. So here you can observe that these are the particles which are traveling from this inlet and this is the outlet in the continuous domain, or you can say the air zone. This is nothing but the spray intermediate application. So this spray here, these are the different particles here, these are cracked in the Lagrangian manner. And the third example is nothing but the erosion in the pipe. So erosion, in order to track this erosion, in order to capture this erosion, we can use the GPM model setup. Now this is actually addition of the new model in the version 19 into the fluent. So here we have to DPM basis. So the sprinkler is here, right? So sprinkler in order to capture the sprinkler phenomena or inkjet, not in inkjet, but the liquid jet phenomena. So here, if you observe, the first and in the starting, there will be a clear cut interfaces between the two different phases. One is your the one phase and adjacent to that will be the second phase. But as we are moving to the down, this will be this liquid jet is breaking up into the smaller particles, or we can see different sizes of the particles. So this kind of particular phenomenon can be tracked through the VOF approach, and this particular phenomenon can be tracked through the DPM approach. But when we are talking about the in-between phenomenon, that is a transition phenomenon, that has to be captured correctly. So in order to capture that transition phenomenon correctly, and has introduced the VOF to DPM model. So that will be, so it will be able to capture this transition phenomenon between the VOF to the DPM. You just see this animation also. So here, this is the continuous phase, then it is breaking up into the different number of phases. So this is the transition phase. Transition is nothing but the breaking of this continuous flow into the liquid phase. That can be captured by using the way of the DPM approach. Now we'll be looking at demo related multiple applications. So particularly when we are talking about this demo, so this is nothing but a tank plus demo that can be used So here the black portion that you are seeing is nothing but the water, white portion you are seeing is nothing but the air. Here this outlet will be at this location as well as this. This one will be our inlet, this one will be our outlet, and this one will be our second outlet. So here we are switching on the water for a certain period of time through this one, and we will be allowing the water to flow for a certain period of time, and after the certain period of time, we are cutting off that water supply, and we will be converting that Maslow inlet boundary condition to the pressure inlet boundary condition. So according, and after the, due to the siphon effect, this tank is getting emptied. So here we are using the volume of fluid approach in this case, because if you observe here, we have the clear cut interfaces between the two models, or we can say two different phases. One is nothing but air and another one is nothing but the water. So I have actually already loaded this case.